राजशेखर कोटा, फैकल्टी फॉर पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड गवर्नेंस. ओके, एंड रिगार्डिंग माय एकेडमिक्स, आई एम ए यूजीसी नेट क्वालिफाइड असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फॉर हिस्ट्री, एंड आई हैव डन माय पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन इन हिस्ट्री फ्रॉम JNU. एंड रिगार्डिंग पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, आई हैव ऑलमोस्ट अ डिकेड ऑफ एक्वेंटेंस विद दिस सब्जेक्ट. For the first time, I got aware of this subject in 2011. So almost a decade of experience or journey with this subject called public administration. Is there any reason, or am I getting reason? Okay. But I have given my interview with public administration as an optional. So never I touched history. And regarding this subject called public administration, how many of you know something about public administration? At least maybe one word, something administration or maybe public, at least. No, I think how many of you here are from BTech engineering? I think engineering people can define these things. Public administration is administration dealing with public. How many from public administration has their degree course? I have seen you somewhere. You no, right? Okay. Anyone? No one. Good. So how many of you fixed that I'll be taking public administration as an optional? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, fine, nice. So no idea about public administration. Fine. So I'll be taking 1 hour class today, 1 hour, and for the next 3 days, 1 hour class I'll be taking. So the course name is pre-course. Today I'll be just trying to touch upon the orientation. Okay. What is the purpose of orientation? Why do we go for orientation? Market propaganda. What for we give an orientation session? Good. To give an overview of the subject. Next, anyone? Why do we give orientation? Introduction to what? To the subject. Fine. See, there is a person called Herbert Simon. Maybe some of you might have heard this guy. This person got Nobel Prize. Okay, we'll be discussing that person in the public administration. Okay, he got Nobel Prize because he gave a theory regarding how decisions are taken. Every one of us takes decision, right, in our life. For example, coming to whether to prepare for civils or not. Is it a decision or not? Important decision. On what basis you have taken that decision? Some emotions, some facts, yes or no? So he is the person, Herbert Simon is the person who understood or who analyzed how decisions are being taken in an organization, at an individual as well as an organization. Okay. So if you take a decision in your life based on facts, it will be more rational decision. Yes or no? What is rational? What is rational? Logical. So when you take a decision in your life based on facts, not on emotions, then you will arrive at a rational decision. So now, taking clue from this guy Herbert Simon, the purpose of orientation session is to give you information so that you will take a decision whether to choose this optional or not to choose this optional. This is not a marketing propaganda. Why? Because your life will be at stake. There are many people who have taken optional in their first attempt, second attempt, and third attempt. They'll write with one subject, and after that, they'll change their optional. Yes or no? But they'll waste 3 to 4 years of their time. So, the purpose of this orientation session is to give you information. What is this subject called public administration? Now it's your choice whether to take this course or not. But your decision will be based on the information. So it will be surely a rational decision. Okay, so that is what the primary intention of having an orientation class. It's not just a marketing propaganda. Okay, because the life of the student will be at stake. Okay, so just the images which I have mentioned, which I have given there, they have a relevance to the subject. The first one is the parliament, the legislature. We'll be discussing about that. What is the role played by the legislature in the administration? Then who is that person? Oh, fine, okay. And civil, he is giving taking a picture with civil servants. Then judiciary, I think you know this person, right? Fine. Police, very important. There is a chapter called Law and Order Administration, and every one of us here aware of the role played by the police during pandemic, right? Almost they work for 24/7. So we'll be discussing, there is a chapter called Law and Order. There we'll be discussing what is the police role, how they are functioning, what are the various committees that were constituted to suggest reforms. Whether the police in this country functioning effectively all the times? No, we have seen custodial deaths, sexual harassment by even police personnel. So if police are functioning efficiently, why these things will happen, right? Then hero at district, collector, and I think every one of you aspiring for that. How many of you want to go for IPS first? Oh, this many. No, good. Nice. So this will be the lecture plan for today. Okay. So I think I may not finish all the 5 or 6 domains which I have mentioned there, but the class will be as per this structure. Okay. The first thing is, what is the role played by an optional? Does optional have any significant role in your success? Yes or no? How many marks? 500, 250, 250, right? Now see, if you don't get good score in your optional, getting a rank in UPSC will be a dream. Many people, they lost their rank because they haven't scored well in their optional. So you have to be careful before choosing an optional. Never take an optional by craziness. Okay. Sir, I want to take optional Pali, sir. Pali or Prakrit. What do you do with these options? Because no one has taken Pali and Prakrit. Can you afford taking Pali and Prakrit? No. But when you take an optional, you have to be very careful because your optional score will decide your rank. There are many people who lost their attempts because of their optional. So never be arbitrary. Never take optional in a random manner. That is the first thing which you have to emphasize upon, which you have to take care. Next thing, what is public administration? I will not go into the technical details, but in a layman terms, let us understand what is public administration, what the subject deals with. Now, if I say about history, what is history? Don't say Ashoka. What is history? Study of the past. You have something to define history. Good. It is understanding of the evolution of the societies, cultural societies. So similarly, when I say public administration, at least you should be in a position to define what is public administration, right? Bureaucracy is, what is bureaucracy? Someone who told that? You? What is bureaucracy? Of course, you all people are aspiring for that. You want to be into the bureaucracy, right? Public servants, good. There is a chapter. We'll be discussing about bureaucracy. What are the features of bureaucracy? And what are the expectations on part of an IAS officer and IPS officer? Okay, that every topic will be part of this particular course. Now the positives and some issues. I have told you, you have to take a very logical decision. I should not elevate public administration like KGF. I should not elevate it, right? At least I should do a critical appraisal. What are the positives and what are the issues also? You should understand that, okay? Otherwise, if you just get carried away by the positives, then I think you know what are the implications of it, right? So I'll be doing a critical appraisal and genuine critical appraisal, okay? Syllabus overview. So maybe tomorrow I'll be going into each and every topic. What is the content of each and every topic? Just on a surface level. But today I'll be going for a syllabus overview if the time permits. Then the strategy to be followed to score the maximum marks. Every subject have certain strategy. And of course, civils preparation is based on your strategy. You should have some approach how to get through this exam. And everyone will have their own approach. It's not some ex got successful, some ex person was successful in civils. The same strategy will be applicable to you. How many of you believe that? Most of us do not believe. Every one of us have the, you know, one type of approach towards civils, right? So what is the strategy that to be taken into consideration or to be adopted while preparing for this optional called public administration? 2019, the top ranker is from public administration. 2019, many people got good marks in public administration. Sources to read. What are the books? Okay. What are the popular books? Okay. How many of you came here to do PhD in public administration? How many of you came here to do PhD in public administration, a doctorate? No? So what for you came here? To clear this exam, right? So don't keep a rack of books in your house or maybe in your room. No, most of the times when you go to civil aspirant room, no, you'll find a list of books like a lawyer. No need, just 3-4 books are sufficient. For paper 1, 2-3 books, and for paper 2, 2-3 books. Current affairs is the most important area for public administration. I think no other optional needs that much. You have to emphasize that much on current affairs for public administration. No other optional needs that much of emphasis. For example, paper two almost covers current affairs. Recently, 15th Finance Commission released a report. How many of you read that? 15th Finance Commission. అసలు అది తెలియ తెలియదు సార్ అసలు ఏంటి అది 15th ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్ ఫస్ట్ బట్ రీసెంట్లీ దే రిలీజ్డ్ ఎ రిపోర్ట్ ద ప్రైమరీ ఫంక్షన్ ఆఫ్ 15th ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ 15 ఎనీ ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్ ఈస్ దట్ ఇట్ విల్ టెల్ టు ద గవర్నమెంట్ సీ దిస్ మచ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఫండ్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ టు ద స్టేట్స్ సో యాజ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్ సెంట్రల్ గవర్నమెంట్ విల్ కలెక్ట్ ట్యాక్సెస్ రైట్ యాజ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్యాక్సెస్ 41% ఆఫ్ ద ట్యాక్సెస్ షుడ్ గో టు ద స్టేట్స్ Every state will be part of it. Okay, that recommendation will be given by the Finance Commission. So that is a current affair issue you'll be discussing. We'll be discussing here. Now, recently, government have passed information technology guidelines. Yes or no? What is that? Some guidelines to deal with information technology, sir. That's all right. To regulate digital media platforms, your Amazon Prime Video, ఇంకోటి ఏదో ఉంది ఏంటది Netflix, see, updated. So now we have a topic called e-governance and media. Okay, what is the role played by media in enforcing accountability? I'll be defining what is accountability later. Now, in that particular context, the recent guidelines issued by government is very much important. So every day, at least 5 or 10 topics you'll read in newspapers, which are very much relevant to public administration. So it's most dynamic subject in that sense. Okay. So the first thing, what is the role played by an optional? We have discussed. So now the second point. What is, and one more point to add, whether you are an IAS officer or IPS officer or maybe any other central civil service officer, your cadre will be based or your rank will be based on this particular score. Most of the people, though they aspire for IAS, they couldn't get because their optional score will be less. Optional score, if you get very, of course, if you get 220, 230 in optional, you cannot pull in another subject. It's not such easy task. Getting high score in GS paper 2, GS paper 3, it's not such an easy task. So you have to do justice to your optional. Now, what is public administration? The first question which I asked. Now, simply put it, it is all about what the government does and how it is being done. I'm not giving any technical definition, boss. Just in layman terms, I'm trying to discuss in a very simple terms. The subject, the nature of subject is almost these five features are part of it. First thing is what the government does and how it is being done. What the government do? Policies. Tell me any one policy. Niti Aayog. But you're very much confident that government is doing something or the other, right? It is not sitting idle there. Listen here. Now, for example, take this Modi government. Modi government wants to achieve a developmental state. Yes or no? Okay. Now it sets what you call a vision called Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. Now don't ask me meaning of that because I don't know Hindi. Okay. But I think you can make a sense out of it. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. Okay. Now how government will be going to achieve that? Now who will play a very significant role in taking that vision forward? Bureaucracy. Can any state or can any government in this world can exist without the support of bureaucracy? Now the government or the home minister, they can say great, great things, but without the support of the bureaucracy, without the support of civil servants, can the government implement that? Now let us bring the examples of state governments here. One of the reason why the Chandrababu Naidu government lost the elections in 2019, one of the reason, not don't attribute to Lokesh again, just one of the reason, it is because they are not able to guide the government, not able to guide the civil servants or the bureaucracy in a proper manner. They couldn't give directions and they couldn't implement those directions effectively. One of the reason. Today, to assess the success or failure of a government, the bureaucratic function is very much important. Today, take KCR here, or maybe take Jagan Mohan Reddy there. To see that these two governments are functioning effectively, it can only be done by looking into the bureaucratic function. Now, for example, doubling of farmers' income. Have you heard this term? Government wants to double the farmers' income. As part of it, the recent three laws which were passed by the government, I think you are aware of those laws, Punjab, Haryana protest and everything. Now, these three laws are the mechanisms or the ways through which that government will achieve the target of doubling of farmers' income. But who will be implementing those laws? So the public administration is all about what the government does and how it will implement or how that is being done. So it will be like both administration also deals with the philosophy of the state. Here, for example, philosophy of the state is developmental state or Sabka Saath or Sabka Vikas. I'll be discussing what is philosophy of the state and everything in detail, but just in a layman terms, you understand public administration is all about what government does and how it is being done. Now, administration is present at various levels. You have administration at central level, You have legislature, you have executive, you have cabinet secretariat, you have prime minister office. They play some or the other role, right? In implementing some policies or in implementing certain schemes. At state level, we have state government, high court, chief secretary, state secretariat. Nearby place, we can, we have it, okay? Now, it's not these two levels. There is one more level called district level. Now, district magistrate. Who is the district magistrate? District collector. Now, we have very important role to play at the district level, right? There also certain administration happens. All the schemes will be implemented at the district level. Now, in addition to these three institutions, we also have local bodies. Recently, JHMC elections. Who won that? Who won those elections? Majority TRS. Okay. Now, whether the JHMC have any role to play in administration or not? Who will be maintaining these roads, street lighting, and all this in Hyderabad? This JHMC, Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation. We also have institutions in rural areas. Any institution, can you name one single institution? Grama Panchayat, Sarpanch. Then we have Jilla Parishad. These elections, I think, were being held in Andhra Pradesh right now. So administration happens at all levels, not just confined to the national level. And we'll be discussing administration at all levels. We have local governance focusing on rural areas and urban areas. We have state government. There we'll be discussing every institution which is present at the state level. Then at national level, we'll be discussing all the institutions because they have a very important role to play in the administration. So this is one, one way of understanding public administration. Next, third thing is it is contextual. What is context? This question was asked in 2018, I think. Public administration is contextual. What is contextual? What is context? Referring a particular? What is context? Maybe referring a particular time period. Now see, the way the civil servant of 21st century, especially take 2021, the way civil servant have to function in 2021 and the way he used to function in 1990 and the way a civil servant used to function in 1950 is the same. What is the difference? Now people expectations are more. People want quality services. People want quality goods. People want services in a time-bound manner. People are more politically aware. So administration also changing. So public administration is influenced by the time. During colonial government also we have administration, right? Colonial people ruled us for how many years? 200 years. They ruled because they got the support of locals, but they used this instrument called bureaucracy. Because of that, they can rule this country for 200 years. But the way the civil servant during colonial government functioned and the way he is functioning now is the same? No, because context influences the nature and content of public administration. Do we have Niti Aayog in 2010? What was the institution then? Now we have another institution called. There is a difference in the roles they have to perform. Yes or no? Both are same. What is one difference which you can tell? Okay, previously we used to have 5-year plans. Now we don't have any 5-year plans. Okay. Second thing, planning commission used to follow a top-down approach, okay? But now Niti Aayog focuses on bottom-up approach, okay, it emphasizes on things like cooperative and competitive federalism. Don't worry, these terms may be new to you. Of course, I think some students from polity can make sense out of these terms. Otherwise, we'll be defining what is cooperative, what is competitive federalism. But my point here is to drive a point. My point here is to show that administration nature is being changed based on the context. And the whole evolution of this discipline called public administration. Public administration is not like a Newton's theory. What is Newton's third law? Newton's third law. Chala confident ga chepparu. What is poverty? When I ask Newton's third law, you are so much confident in defining it, right? Right? Everyone, I think, made a right guess. But when I asked poverty, we all knew about poverty because we see, once we step out, we can see the poverty, right? But we cannot define it. This is the beauty, or this is the difference between a science subject and an art subject. In science, you will have a clear definition. Okay? If you store an apple upward, it will fall down because there is a gravity. But here we don't have a clear definition, right? Even public administration do not have a clear definition. The definition itself is evolving. The way public administration as a subject defined in 1900 was different. The way public administration was defined in 1940 during the World War period, it is different. The way public administration was defined in 1970 was different. The way it is being defined in 21st century is different because the context changed. And what is that contextual changes? We'll be discussing as part of the subject. Now, what happened in 1880s? What happened in 1990s? I think some people might aware of a term called LPG. What is that? So confident, but what is that? I asked, what is LPG? Something related to economic reforms, fine. But surely it will influence administration. It will surely have an influence on administration. Because now the collector or maybe the entire administration have to function within the LPG reforms, within the ambit of LPG reforms. And we'll be discussing that, how administration got changed. Only point which I want to emphasize here is that contextual situations have an influence on the nature and content of public administration. Okay. Now it is about understanding of all the organizations. This is one area which we'll be discussing in public administration. What is an organization? Now take this institute. Is it an organization? It is an organization. Maybe small organization, but it's an organization, right? Every organization has some or the other purpose. What is the purpose of this organization? To earn profit. Manasula one akade champion, please. To give quality education so that more number of ranks will get. Okay. Now we have a purpose for it. What is the purpose of bureaucracy? Bureaucracy is also an organization, right? It also have a purpose. What is that purpose? Last point. To serve the public. Is there any civil servant who want, now I think you people want to become a civil servant. How many of you want to become a civil servant because there is a lot of power in it, there is a lot of money you can make, and there is a lot of authority, and when we come, you know, the whole society watches us, and we'll get a lot of dowry. Everything is recorded, sir, why should we say it? If an IAS officer is getting married, you know, almost the budget of a Chhattisgarh will be transferred, right? Almost some crores of dowry, 50, 100, 200, you have to demand.
But okay.
What it can be any motive, but we need you to clear civil services, that's all. But theoretically, a civil servant primary role is to serve the public. Public interest is the how you will defend public interest? Needs of the public. Whether youth of this country have the same interest of an adult person? No, right? Or maybe of a farmer? Surely. But the government, the administration has to make sure that every person interest is served. Not only the elite people. Who are the elite people? నేనే సార్ ఎలైట్ అని. హూ ఆర్ ద ఎలైట్ పీపుల్ ఇన్ ద సొసైటీ? రిచ్ పీపుల్. రిచ్ ఇన్ ఎకనామిక్ టర్మ్స్, ఆల్సో ఇన్ సోషల్ టర్మ్స్. ఓకే, నా గవర్నమెంట్ షుడ్ నాట్ సర్వ్ ఓన్లీ ద ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దోస్ ఎలైట్ పీపుల్, రైట్? నౌ టేక్ అ గవర్నమెంట్. So the administration also should serve that only committee, only community. Now what will happen if he serves that particular community? Is it justice? Can we see those type of instances happening? No, every government is serving the entire public. Okay, thanks, you have some awareness. Okay, good. So yeah, the last point is every civil servant who is entering into the system, he always should have a commitment towards public interest. His his self interest or his vested interest should not be the prime motive. What is going to benefit the large public? Every action or inaction, commission or omission, he has to make sure that public interest is served. This is the only goal a civil servant have throughout his career. There is no secondary goal, and it is not it's non-negotiable. Okay, how many of you here are having of that much commitment? Why you're even you don't have that much commitment? Sir, let me first clear, sir, then we will see. You will clear. If you have that interest, you will clear, no doubt, because that interest will drive you. Okay, now as I promised, critical appraisal of public administration. It looks like a marketing slide, but it's a genuine slide, boss. Okay, now what is the advantage if you take public administration as an option? Is there any advantage? First thing which I have to make clear, whatever optional you take, if you are committed, you will make through, you'll get through this exam. It need not be this particular optional. That may be very clear. Okay, but if you take this particular optional, what is the advantage you'll get? Okay, every optional will have certain advantages. So unfortunately, public administration also have certain advantages. Okay, first advantage is, as you want to become a civil servant, the primary function of a civil servant is administration. So once you understand the subject is all about administration, how recruitment will happen, what is the training module given to an IAS and IPS officer, how many months training will be given to an IAS officer? 2 years. 2 years for IAS, IPS training. Okay, so what are the career advancement available to the civil servants. And also in addition to that, we'll be discussing how the administration happened at various levels of the government. So now it will give you an acquaintance of the administration government functioning. And once you enter into the system, anyhow, you have to do the same thing. But now you can ask me a question. Sir, if I don't take this optional, can't I become a good administrator? I didn't say that. I said, if you take this optional, it will help you to become a good administrator. Okay. Now, the second point is very genuine point, which you can take seriously. There is a subject called governance in JS paper 2. So a public administration student do not need any preparation for governance. He can, because the topics which we discuss here, it will be more than sufficient to write a very good answer in governance. So there, surely public administration student will have an advantage. Okay. Next, polity. We have in paper 2 chapters like constitution, union executive, judiciary, a legislature, and at state level also we have these institutions. We have the Panchayati Raj institutions, constitution and statutory bodies will be discussing. Everything will be covered in your polity. So you will have advantage also. Again, the same question. If I don't take this optional, don't I have an advantage in these subjects? No, still you will have. But here, if you take public administration optional, you'll have more ease in writing answers in governance and also to a certain extent polity. There is no doubt in it. It's not an exaggeration, right? Next is GS paper 3. In GS paper 3 is basically an economy related paper, right? We have chapters like disaster management in GS paper 3. In public administration, we'll be discussing disaster management. There is a subtopic called disaster management. Do the civil services have any role to play in disaster management? Very important role they have, right? Particularly. For example, the coastal districts of Andhra Pradesh particularly witness cyclones every year. There, the civil services play a very significant role. So there, yes, you don't need any special preparation to write an answer on disaster management. And we also have topic like planning and resource mobilization in GS paper 3. In paper 2 of public administration, we have a chapter called planning and priorities. There we'll be discussing what is planning, what is the role played by planning commission, and also Niti Aayog objectives, and to what extent Niti Aayog was successful. All those concepts we'll be discussing. So you'll be in a better position to answer, to write an answer from planning and resources, a subtopic in JS paper 3. Ethics. Why UPSC introduced ethics? What to test? To test values that are very much important for a civil servant. Now in public administration, there are many chapters which focus on those values. For example, Nolan Committee is there, which mentions things like impartiality, integrity, honesty, truthfulness. Of course, honesty, truthfulness, one and same. So these are the things which we will teach as part of public administration. So in the GS paper 4 ethics, things like public service and aptitude and foundation values, we have various chapters in paper 2 and also in paper 1. So there we'll cover this particular topics. In essay paper, every year, yes, there are high chances of a single question from public administration. Unfortunately, 2020, they haven't asked any question. That is what critical appraisal is. But in 2019, they have asked a question where media is the role played by media in democracy. We have a chapter called accountability and control. What is accountability? Accountability. Responsibility for what you're doing. Any other definition? Yes, answerability. Okay. Jawabudaritanam. Accountability means. Okay. So, what is the role played by media in enforcing accountability? Does the media have any role? But there are some TV channels which starts with S. They never criticize a particular government. Meeku telusu, naaku telusu, but we should not reveal the name. Okay, fine. But media has a very important role to play. But unfortunately, because of the hastiness or maybe because of the commercial nature involved, most of the news right now which we are consuming are distorted to a larger extent. Fake news we are consuming. So media plays a very significant role in democracy. And what is that role? What is the relationship between media and democracy? Does media have any role to play in democracy? Can you make some sense, some relation between these two? We'll be defining those concept. And in 2019, an essay was asked on the particular topic. So public administration, one question can be asked in essay from public administration area. And this year 2020, they asked one question on science and technology and one question on history. Culture is what we are. Civilization is what we have. That is what the question. One essay question asked in 2020 question paper. Okay. Now, the last 2 points is syllabus wise is not so vast. And one beauty with this subject is no need to mandap. No need to remember, because if you can understand concept, you will make, you can really convince the examiner there. Because no facts, no maps, just conceptual understanding. If you can relate what is media and what is democracy, if you can define it in your own terms. And the beauty with public administration is every term you can define it in your own terms. Administration you can make, and what a civil servant have to do you can make. You can define it in your own terms. So I think I can confidently say this is the subject which needs less amount of remembering. If you are smart enough to grasp the essence of a particular topic, I think you can do justice to a particular question. Okay, so syllabus wise is not so vast, and also number of facts are very much minimal. So no need to mug up, no need to put lot of stress on your young mind. Okay. Next, the subject is linked with current affairs, which I have told you before. Lot of dynamism is there, lot of dynamism. Every day, if you just open newspaper, you will find just 10 or 15 articles which are important for your public administration. You can find it. Every topic have some or the other relevance to the current affairs. Good, everything is good. Now, what is the other side? Now, if Robo 2.0. The other side is, why the strength of public administration is low in the last 4 or 5 years? You should know that, right? We should not say only one side of, we should not just focus on only one side of the coin. The other side is also there. There was a period, 2011, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, where UPSC optional was like, you know, it's complete harassment on part of UPSC. People used to score single digits. Single digits out of 300. This I'm saying about 2012. Now don't be panicked. 2019 first anchor is public administration. I'm saying about 2012, okay? So 2012, 13, 14, you know, lot of massacre was there from UPSC. The questions were so tough, so complex, more than tough, so complex. So because of that, the average score which the aspirants used to get is very much low compared to other options. And most of the people lost their interview just because of their option called public administration. But from 2016 onwards, this option is doing well. There is no an inch of exaggeration in this particular point. From 2016 onwards, this option is doing good. But the amount of massacre which UPSC unleashed on this option in 2011, 12, 13, 14, made people to leave this option. Okay. Now 2016, many people got 320, 315 in public administration. In 2017, 334, I think the highest score in optional. 2019, again, the topper is from public administration. Now UPS is lenient towards this optional. Okay. Now the nature of questions is also not so tough. They're more application oriented. So no need to read too much, no need to do a lot of research. But if you can understand what is happening in this country, and if you can understand the basic concept, And if you can link these two, you can make a very good answer. So no need to focus more on the statistical or what you call the static information, just current affair and application oriented. But one problem with this optional is that you should able to express yourself. Public administration do not have a ready-made answer. There is no ready-made answer for public administration. Everyone have a perception to write an answer. Now, here you should able to express your views in a very organized manner. That is the only thing where most of the people, you know, they never show interest to public administration option. If you're very much if you can link with current affairs, if you can organize your ideas, suppose if I ask you, what is the role played by women in administration? A simple question. But now you have to organize your thoughts. How many, what are the statistics of women? One or two statistics. How many IAS, women IAS officers are there? How many women IPS officers are there at higher level? So when more women is represented in administration, what will happen? Right? These ideas, if you can make on your own, it will be sufficient for public administration. But writing skills are needed for this subject. To get through this exam called civils, you need writing skills. Okay. But this subject also needs little more writing skills. Okay. It's like your GS paper 2 and ethics also. So that is one issue with public administration optional. And other issue is, by nature, the subject is abstract. If you cannot make sense out of a particular term or maybe a particular concept, it will be a little boring, public administration, because of the abstractness of the subject. Okay. Other than that, there is no issue with the subject as per my knowledge is concerned. No need to do a research whether public administration is good or not, because fine. If you are very much committed, you can challenge even UPS, whatever paper let him set, but still you can get your mark, get your rank. This holds good for every other optional, even to the public administration. Now, let me put it this way. Now, 2012, 13, 14, 15, I have told you that UPSC massacred public administration optional guys. Okay. But there are people who are in top 100. There are people who got IAS in 2012, 13, 14, 15 with public administration as their optional. And why only those people could get? Because they prayed God. Then what? Yes, good. Because they are committed and they have interest towards the subject. So when you come in that particular domain, you will also get through this exam, irrespective of how UPSC tests this paper. But nowadays, 2016 onwards, UPSC is not doing any drama with this paper called public administration. This is for sure. Okay. Now, this is what public administration, we have two papers. First paper is for 250 marks and second paper is for 250, 500. So what we will discuss in paper one, what is there in paper two? Paper one is all about the general administration. Paper two is Indian administration. How administration is there in this country, starting from Kautilya to the recent administrative developments. Okay, that is what we'll cover in paper two. Paper one is all about how public administration as a discipline evolved, when it got evolved, why it evolved first case, in the first sense. So basically theoretical part we'll be discussing in paper one. Evolution and the thought. We have various thinkers. One thinker whose name I have mentioned, who is that? Herbert Simon. We have many thinkers, F.W. Taylor, Karl Marx, Max Weber. Woodrow Wilson is father of public administration. Okay. Very important personality. He started this discipline called public administration to arrest civil aspirants. Okay. But okay, fine. That is one, Woodrow Wilson. So we'll be discussing various thinkers. So it is theoretical in nature. Many theories are there. and no need to mug up those theories. If you can understand the essence of the a particular theory, it will be sufficient. No need to. I think maybe one or two instances you will get where you have to really by heart certain things in public administration. Okay, everything is based on your understanding. So the first chapter, the paper one, is how an administration should be, means how police should function, how a civil servant should function, theoretical part or the ideal part. The second paper is all about how he is functioning right now. What is the deviations? What is the deviation? Why the deviation happened? So the reality is paper two, the ideal part is paper one. Okay, there is a linkage between paper one and paper two. We don't deal these two papers in silos. We link a lot. Okay, now it consists of 12 chapters and 14 chapters. Sir, 12 plus 14, 26, and you said syllabus is almost very less. It can be finished in 3 months. Okay, there are a lot of overlapping topics here, and we do two topics simultaneously because of the linking. For example, here we'll be discussing personal administration regarding civil servants, their role, and here we'll be discussing about Indian civil services, theoretical part and the existing reality. Okay, so with that, I'll stop. Tomorrow I'll be going for a syllabus overview. Any doubts? Because there is a class at 5 o'clock. So any doubts? Detailed syllabus review will be done tomorrow. Okay, just at surface level we have done something about public administration. Any doubts or any queries or suggestions, whatever you can give. No? What is the difference between public administration and political science? Because many people ask me this question. Public administration came from political science. Yes, true. Woodrow Wilson is the guy who separated public administration from political science. Public administration is the child of the mother called political science. But there is a difference. Because here, the role played by the administration of the bureaucracy, we will discuss. Their political parties, how power is, extracted from the people, how power is distributed, how government is formed. We don't discuss how government is formed, what is their political ideologies or manifestos. We won't discuss. We here focus on the administration. When a particular vision is being set by a particular government, how that vision is being taken forward and how civil servants will implement that. What are the institutions that are there in this country which will implement those policies, schemes, laws and other guidelines issued by the government or maybe the legislature? And what is the role played by the judiciary to enforce accountability on part of administration? Does judiciary have any role? Because an IAS or IPS is not your jagir. You are accountable to someone there, either to a judiciary or to the legislature. You're accountable because you're part of every institution in this country functions in the broader framework of democracy. In democracy, every individual of the state has to be accountable to the public. Okay, tomorrow I'll be discussing syllabus of paper one and paper two. Maybe tomorrow I'll focus on syllabus of paper one, day after tomorrow paper two, detailing will go. Then we will try to see the linking of current affairs with public administration, and we'll be starting our class from Monday. It's just introduction song. The real story starts from Monday. Okay, any doubts? Yeah, why this strategic silence? Strategy plan le kada, just normal, right? Chalo, okay, fine. Tomorrow we'll meet at the same time.